south side of the pier, looking at where the USS Silversides would have been docked, but we're still here. The USS Silversides was a submarine that served our nation during World War II, and after retirement, it was docked here at Navy Pier from 1979 until 1987. The submarine itself was a Gato-class submarine. It was 300 feet long and held a crew of 8 officers and 72 sailors. It was nicknamed the Lucky Boat because during its entire tour, it only lost one man in entire service, which is actually pretty good. It sunk over 50 enemy vessels, which is astonishing to me. 50 enemy vessels during World War II, primarily based in the Pacific. It had 13 total tours during World War II, and it was launched in 1941. It had the most famous medical operation in World War II occur on board. The vessel's surgeon took out an appendix with improvised tools, including dinner knives and dinner forks, and with no anesthetic. During one tour, this is an amazing story, I found this interesting, it was the only United States submarine to actually fly a Japanese flag while attacking a fleet. It was an accident. It was actually submerged, and what happened is it got caught in Japanese fishing nets, which happened to have Japanese flags on it. So on the periscope, it was the Japanese fishing net with the Japanese flag on it while it was attacking Japanese vessels. So it was kind of interesting. On accident, and they actually went covert during World War II. So in 1972, it was officially designated a Mobile National Historic Landmark. This was before it was docked here. In 1973, it was docked at Navy Pier as a part of the Combined Great Lakes Naval Association efforts to kind of preserve the entire thing. It was restored by a small crew, and in 1979, it was 7 years after it first docked here, the number 3 engine was refurbished and restarted, which was the first time since 1946 that engine had actually worked. In 1985, sadly, the city of Chicago evicted the USS Silversides from its docks. Mayor Washington, at the time, decided that it wasn't really worth it to have that submarine there, since all the boats that are currently docked here since 1985 have paid rent, and they actually provide quite a lot of funding. So since the Silversides didn't pay rent, Mayor Washington felt that this historic monument didn't belong here. So it was evicted, and it currently resides somewhere in Michigan. So unfortunately, Chicago, we have no submarine dock here anymore.